Here we go again, game two between Pekar and Ojama. And we see Sandros actually looks kind of annoying for Ojama's team. That might be a setup Megina, since he already has Mantine, which can check Greninja. Yeah, Rocks are gonna be on the Powdon. Mega Mawile also looks annoying for Ojama, like he can't switch into that at all. And the Pekka looks to have multiple Greninja checks, and Ojama can also never lock. Like, Greninja is like bad in this match, because there's a Mantine for the water moves, and if he locks into Dart move, that gives either Mawile a switch, or that gives Megina a switch, and if Megina is a setup variant, that can be really bad for Ojama, because if that Megina has Focus Blast plus Ice Beam for his other mons, it kind of just wins with some chip. Like, it just needs chip on the Lily and on the DNC. Or if the last move is Flash Cannon, it might just go hard through Ojama's team. But yeah, turn 1, Ojama is obviously going to switch out Scouting for Scarf Kartana. Pekka makes a good play because Ojama is either going to go Torn or Ferrothorn there to scout for Scarf Smart Strike or Scarf, Scarf Smart Strike. So he makes a good double into Sandros, which covers both. Now Ojama, I don't know if he's rocks DNC or rocks Ferrothorn, we'll have to see that. But Pekka can definitely go for Focus Blast here. Like, Ojama has no switch-ins for Sandros. I guess a potential play here is going into Gliscor on a Focus Blast and then pivoting into DNC on a Hidden Power. Which I'm not sure if this is Hidden Power Ice or Hidden Power Flying. We have seen Hidden Power Flying a few times, I think by Mimolet. I think the Gliscor is definitely SD on Ojama's team, as he does decide to get up the rocks there. And yeah, he doesn't want to sack the Ferrothorn, he wants to keep this around still. And yeah, also Scarf Katana can be really scary for Ojama if his Tornadus gets weakened. Because Ferrothorn is already weakened, which is like his other Leaf Blade resist. But yeah, he's definitely going to switch out here. I assume he's going to try to pivot from either, like, I guess Hard Lele is also a potential play because it covers a Focus Blast. He could have gone Hard Lele, but he goes Gliscor. And I think he's going to pivot into either Lele or DNC, predicting the Hidden Power Ice or Fly. Yeah, that looks like it's Hidden Power Ice. And I think we're going to see just the HP Fire or Moonblast here from the DNC. Probably a Moonblast. Goes for Hidden Power Fire instead. Yeah, I mean, I guess he predicted the Megina there, or he didn't want to let Megina in. Mawile was never coming out because Mawile has awful speed death. And now Hippowdon could go for Slack Off or playing it safe. Could also go for Rocks, because it's unlikely that the DNC is going to stay in here. We're most likely going to see a switch from Ojama into one of his flying types, either the Gliscor or the Tornadus. So yeah, I think you go for Rocks here, because it's unlikely that the DNC stays in. Also, you have to run a Kulk, obviously, if you lift two Moonblasts. But yeah, let's go for Rocks. Torn comes out. So knowing Ojama, this is going to be a Hurricane Tornadus with Taunt, Knockoff, and Defog. And I assume he just goes for Knockoff here. Yep, and that does a lot, so it's not Z move Thunderous. It's Assault with Thunderous? Hello, who is this? That's not a set you would expect. So now I think we can just see a T-Bolt here from Pekka, because Ojama already Mega did DNC, which means the bulk from DNC is less. And he doesn't really have good switch-ins. His Feral is also low. So T-Bolt seems really free for Pekka. Even if Gliscor comes out, then he can probably HPS the next turn. Yeah, if Ojama has U-turn, he's gonna click it, but I assume he's Taunt Tornadus. He loves that set. He also used it to qualify for ulti. But yeah, this matchup looks really hard for Ojama. I don't know if he can win it. So Lele comes out, which can probably live anyone hit. T-Bolt is gonna do a lot, 60. Now he can scare this out with Scarf Psyshock or Psychic. Pekka doesn't have a great switch-in for this, especially if his Megina is offensive. Kartana and Mawile both have bad speed death, so they are not switch-ins either. So he might just sack the Sandros since Rocks are up and it's like super low. And he doesn't really need it to win. Why is he Assault Vest? He already has a Mantine to deal with. He has a Mantine, dude. Like, why is he Assault Vest? Is this Mantine more Fistiff orientated? That could be it. So Kartana comes out and Kartana is just gonna click Knockoff here. Because there's no reason to click Smart Strike. Because if you click Smart Strike as Ojama goes Ferrothorn, that makes you look like a fool and that accomplishes absolutely nothing. Also, Leaf Blade into Ferro or Torn could be really bad. So Knockoff is just the perfect mid-ground here, as it will kill the Lily and it will hurt the Ferro, potentially killing it or 2-hit KOing it. Will also hurt the Tornadus and get rid of a most likely Rocky Helmet. I think the Z-Move user on Ojama's team is either the Greninja, or he doesn't have a Z-Move user if he specs Greninja. But yeah, either the Torn or the Ferro is gonna come out. Knock's definitely the play here. There's no reason to sack the Lily just yet. It can take one more rocks switch in. Yeah, I'm thinking the Zemofuse on Packard side is the Megina, because he just revealed Assault Vest Zandarus. And the Waltz, the Mantine, and the Hippowdon are both going to be leftovers. So I think we're going to see a knockoff here if the Ferrothorn comes out and lives on one. So now Jama can save this as a fodder and switch out into Dianthe here. Another potential play that would have been Greninja if he's Z-move, but since he didn't go Greninja, I think he's not Z-move. So Dianthe can scare this out. Pekka does not have a great switch in for this at all. Like, what's he gonna switch into? Like, I don't know if Hippowdon takes two, because Hippowdon is at 80 after rocks. He has to Kalki. If Hippowdon takes two Moonblast, then he can go Hippowdon. He goes Mantine instead. I still think he wants to keep this around in case the Greninja is Ash. So he might want to try to pivot from Mantine into Hippowdon. Yeah, yeah. Predicting a Diamond Storm, which Ojama is definitely going to click Diamond Storm here. Exactly. That Moonblast did 42, so that Mantine is definitely not as spadef, yeah, as you would think at Team Preview. So we're going to see a slack off here most likely from the Hippowdon. Yeah, just a safe play in case the DNC stays in. Ojama goes into Torn, and we're going to see either a Hurricane or a Taunt here from the Torn. I guess he might have, yeah, like I said already, probably Taunt on this Torn, which can prevent the Megina from setting up a Shift Gear or a Trick Room, which is cool for Ojama. Now, since he already showed rocks on the Ferrothorn, I was gonna say this is most likely rock SD on the Gliscor. And now we can see an Earthquake here from Ojama, or Ice Fang or Knockoff. We just see an Earthquake. I think it's just gonna Whirlwind out as long as he doesn't hit himself. Drags the Pharaoh out, which dies, so no Death Water for Ojama. Now, the thing is, if he's Ash Ninja, he can't really bring that out. Because if he locks into a water move, one, that lets the Mantine heal. If he locks into a dark move, that two, lets the Megina set up potentially. So it's kind of a tough situation for Ojama. I think he's just going to go into Tornadus, because that's most likely Taunt, which is Ojama's favorite set, just to shut down fat walls like packs with Taunt so they can toxic you. I'm a big fan of that set. I think people need to use offensive Taunt Tornadus more. That's also pretty fire. I know Ricardo also loves that set. I feel like it's hard to build with offensive Taunt though, because you don't check Kartana as well. And also, like, max HP is just amazing on Tornadus, because you can always pivot into Greninja to scout the set usually. Unless it's like Protean Life Orb Ice Beam, which is really uncommon these days. Like, super, super uncommon. I think he has to go into Tornadus. The Lily just is Scarf and doesn't do enough damage, I don't think. Dianthe also cannot kill it. Like I said, Greninja gives, like, unless he's Protean Greninja. If he's Protean Greninja, then he can go to it. But if he's Ash Ninja, then he can't go to it, because that will either let the Mantine heal with the Water Absorb, or it will give the Megina setup if it locks into a Dark Move. So I think Taunt is definitely the play, exactly. So we could see either a Hurricane or a Taunt from Ojama here. Hippowdon already revealed rocks. What else did it reveal? Slack Off and Whirlwind. It's pretty obvious that the last move is Earthquake, as he hits himself, which is annoying for Packard, but I think he still wins anyway, because this matchup is so, like, in Packard's favor. If he loses this matchup, he should retire from Pokemon, just saying. So he taunts there just in case the Hurricane misses, so really good play on Ojama's part. Preventing the Hippowdon from heal, gets him on the Slack Off, and now he's just free the Hurricane here. Super free Hurricane. The Hippowdon is gonna live on one and go down, because Earthquake obviously doesn't affect that. I mean, it's pretty much gonna go down. He's just gonna sack it to a knockoff as he gets rid of the leftovers right there. And now he could go, I was gonna say, either Morwell or Megina. And we're just gonna see a Play Rough here. Ojama has no Play Rough resist at this point. And Packard knows that this Tornadus has knockoff, Hurricane, Taunt, and most likely Defog in the last slot. So he knows it doesn't have Heat Wave, so Mora was definitely a fine play to make, and he can just click Play Rough here. And Ojama is just gonna have to pick as long as it connects. I guess if he has Ice Punch, that's also a potential play right here. I think Ojama is probably just gonna sack the Tapu Lele, because the Lele is really low already. So yeah, I guess if you don't want to risk missing, you click Ice Punch here. Yeah, he really doesn't have a switch in, and the Lele is super low. And Lele also gives Megina setup, so there's no reason to keep Lele around. And Tornadus is still really cool, can potentially taunt Megina, preventing from Shift Gearing or Trick Rooming up, so he should not sack the Tornadus at all. Like, Taunt is like one of the mons that can win this game for Ojama. Potentially with Hurricane confusing Packard's team at the end of the game. if he doesn't have another out, that might have to be Ojama's out. Because otherwise, like, most of his other mons just give the Megina setup. So he might just have to, like, Hurricane Confuse Megina later on. So obviously he wants to switch here and keep this around, like I said. Yeah, I don't know Pekka's moveset. I mean, Plerov, as long as it hits, gets one right here. So I think you click Plerov. If you have a better mid ground that covers everything, like, I guess you don't want, no, you don't, I don't think you want to click knockoff. How healthy is the DNC's at 44, so after rocks it's at 32, so I don't know if the DNC would die to a knockoff, so I don't think you click that. And I also don't think you click Ice Punch. Well, Ice Punch is an option, I guess, because if Gren comes out, like I said, if it's Ash Gren, it potentially gives Megina setup, or it heals Mantine if it goes for a water move. How healthy is the Mantine? I think it lives rock. I think it's at 40-ish, so it's at 15 after rocks. I definitely think Lilla is like useless, kind of, at this point, so he should sack it. Then his timer is so low, so Lilla comes out. Do we see Ice Punch, or do we see Plerov or knockoff? Plerov and misses. Okay, that's annoying for Paycard, because now he's gonna have to take a hit. We could see Psyshock, Psychic, or HP Fire here. I think Packard is just gonna stay in, knowing that he can live any one hit. And yeah, this is fine for him, because Scarf Katana looks really good. Like, he just needs to chip the Tornadoes a bit more. Like, rocks are already up. He needs to chip Torn a bit, and he can just win with Scarf Katana. Well, he doesn't even need to Leaf Blade sweep. He can also Smart Strike sweep, potentially. Yeah, if he gets a little bit more chip on Gwen, he can also Smart Strike sweep. And yeah, so he goes for knockoff this time. And yeah, Ojama has to go like Gliscor or Torn again. Yeah, goes Gliscor. Yeah, actually he couldn't go Torn, because Torn would only beat Maul through Hex. My bad, yeah. So Gliscor comes out, and he's probably just gonna go Mantine here. Predicting Earthquake, and Mantine doesn't really do anything in this game. And if Gliscor doesn't have like a move to kill this, like, I don't know if knockoff even kills, or what Gliscor's last move is. I guess if it's Facade it might kill, but I think we're gonna see a Ruth here from Paycard keeping this around. And oh yeah, the reason, why did Ojama not, wait, if Ojama killed the Mantine there, what happened then? Would he have lost to, I guess he just didn't have a move to kill it, but he goes for Hidden Power Fire there just in case. Yeah, one of the steals come out, and he obviously didn't want to sack the Mantine, because if he loses the Mantine, he can lose to Greninja Hydro Pump, potentially. So protects that Skald, what Cartana locks into. I think he might want to switch out into Tornadus here. Or he, no, I think he can just sack this, honestly, yeah. So I guess he's just going to sack it right here. Then he has to go into Torn afterwards. And because Torn is like the one mon that can Torn Megina, which means Megina can set up. So yeah, I mean, rocks are up, so I don't think he wants to go hard into Tornadus and let it get chipped, because if, yeah. I mean, he knows it's locked into Leaf Blade, but I still think he's just gonna sack DNC. Also, some of Ojama's nicknames are really cool, and some of Ojama's nicknames are not that great in my opinion, but yeah, not trying to have beef with the Kingpin. So Torn comes out, he's just gonna click Hurricane here, pretty sure. Clicks knockoff. Damn, I'm bad, dude. Thought he would click. Oh yeah, knockoff was the play, I guess, in the sense that if the card stayed in, it would have gotten rid of the scarf. I would have clicked Hurricane there personally. Maybe I'm just bad. So now we know confirmed that it's Z-move Megina. And I guess he just expects him to not go for Trick Room or for Shift Gear right there, because Paycard knows that Ojama has Taunt, so he has no reason to go for Shift Gear, Calm Mind, or Trick Room. So he hard Hurricane's trying to get the confusion. Now Earthquake doesn't even kill, confirming that it's a bulky Trick Room Megina, as he just revealed the Trick Room. And yeah, Megina just wins at this point. If he has if he locks into Water Shuriken, which is the only way to get rid of this. No, he can't do that. He can just go, like, this game is so over for Paycard. Like, the only way to be faster with Greninja is Water Shuriken, which would heal the Mantine as he goes Mantine. So he obviously cannot go for Water Shuriken, so he obviously has to go for Dark Pulse. Pekka didn't want to miss, I guess he didn't want to stay in and miss a Flurkan. He probably didn't have a 100% accurate move, so he didn't want to miss Flurkan. So he switches Mantine, and Mantine is faster because of the Trick Room, which is really funny. And yeah, that is doing 30-ish, which, and 39 at one point, which confirms that his Mantine has some sort of Fist Def investment. I think we already knew that from earlier, but this confirms it. So yeah, this game is over. Even if the Mantine gets flinched down somehow, which he gets the Toxic off, which guarantees the win. Even if Mantine got flinched down, he locked into Dark Pulse. He didn't lock into Shuriken. If he locked into Shuriken, Mantine could have healed. If he locks into Dark Pulse and even if he flinches the Mantine, Scarf Katana could have obviously came in and revenged the Greninja with Leaf Blade. So the game was over no matter what. Really bad matchup for Ojama. He tried with the Hurricane on the Megina to confuse it. He knew that Taunt wasn't the play because Pekka was going to predict the Taunt and either go for... he was going to go for a hard attacking move, predicting him to not go for... predicting him to potentially go for Taunt. And yeah, rough matchup for Ojama. Pekat wins this game. It's 1-1 now, and game 3 is going to decide. Stay tuned for that. Smash that like button if you enjoyed. Stay tuned for more content. Peace out, friends.